Sometime between 3 and 2 million years ago, in North and South America, an important chapter in the evolution of life on Earth was unfolding that would shape the ecosystems of both continents and indeed the rest of the world for ages to come. In time, this significant event would be named the Great American Biotic Interchange. Prior to this biotic interchange between 7 and 3 million years ago, North and South America looked very different to how they appear today. Both continents had yet to physically connect and were separated by a narrow sea. In the north, ecosystems were overwhelmingly dominated by mammals, such as bears, camels, and the ancestors of dogs, cats, and horses, as well as strange animals like giant rodents, Terpsichthyodontidae. The climate in North America was savanna-like around the east coast, with drier and more arid conditions in the Midwest. Mammals had evolved quite differently due to what has been called their splendid isolation. Marsupials, or pouch-bearing mammals, dominated the faunas there. There were also some unusual animals, like large flightless pterobirds, along with oversized mammals such as the armadillo-like glyptodont, giant ground sloths, giant anteaters, and mega herbivores. The southern climate was vastly different to the north, and for the most part, resembled a tropical rainforest. But these very distinct north and south ecosystems began changing dramatically, caused by the connection between the North and South American continents via a land bridge known as the Isthmus of Panama. The continents joined as a result of slow and steady continental drift, with the final connection taking place around 3 million years ago. Mass animal migrations took place across the newly formed land bridge, and animals that were once isolated were now able to move freely between the two continents. Many animals that currently reside in North and South America today actually originated from their neighbouring continent. The formation of the Isthmus of Panama also initiated a drastic change in global climates and ocean currents. The separated Atlantic and Pacific Oceans began a process known as thermohaline circulation, a system of deep ocean currents which introduced moisture to the north at a time when the Earth's axis began tilting. This ultimately led to the formation of glaciers in the north, and the wet tropical rainforests of South America developed into drier, more expansive grassland savannas. Some animals had begun venturing from the north before the land bridge had formed, as early as 6 million years ago, specifically the sigmodontine rodents, who favoured the South American lifestyle. These resemble oversized rats and are very diverse today, accounting for some 20% of the mammal species in South America. Members of the Camelidae family, ancestors of modern camels, also made a relatively early move from North to South America, about 3.3 million years ago. But this mass migration was not all directed from the north to the south. Animals originating in South America moved in the opposite direction, towards the north, about 5 million years ago, namely the pterobirds. These flightless birds grew to well over 2 metres in height and were powerful predators. The later animal migrations between North and South America took place over a series of 4 distinct pulses, caused by periods of glaciation in the northern hemisphere. The first of these pulses of animal migration took place about 2.7 million years ago and is termed Gabi 1. This is presumed to have been due to the development of ice sheets in the northern hemisphere, marking the beginning of an ice age. During Gabi 1, small donkey-sized relatives of horses and dog ancestors moved southwards, using the newly formed land bridge, while the giant ground sloth migrated north. The second pulse, or Gabi 2, occurred about 1.8 million years ago. The intensity of glaciation in the northern hemisphere increased at this time, resulting in a cooler climate, forcing the animals to leave their habitats. Gabi 2 saw bears moving from the north to the south, and a giant anteater made the move northwards at this time. The third pulse, known as Gabi 3, was estimated to have occurred about 1.5 million years ago. Glaciers dominated North America, with the climate being much colder than it is now. This resulted in pig-like mammals migrating southwards, and opossums, marsupial mammals that were native to South America, migrated northward. The final pulse of migration, known as Gabi 4, occurred just 125,000 years ago. This event may have been triggered by climate warming during an interglacial period, in which jaguars and other cat-like mammals moved to the south. The animals originating from North America are seen as the more successful group of migrants, particularly the mammals. The ancestral North American mammals had previously had to compete with animals migrating from a completely different area, Eurasia, which periodically connected via a land bridge through Alaska. They also experienced competition with pioneering migrants from South America that had crossed before the land bridge at Panama had formed. They may have already become accustomed to the need to adapt, adjusting to a more mobile, migratory lifestyle. The savanna-type climates of the north played another key role in the successful migration of the northern animals. These animals had already adapted to the sprawling grasslands, which are becoming more widespread in the south. Iconic present-day South American mammals, like llamas and alpacas, are the evolutionary offshoot of the camelids, the ancestors of modern camels. These remain one of the most successful colonizers of the southern continent. However, many of the southern mammals were not as fortunate when they began to migrate further north. Giant vegetarian placental mammals, or mega herbivores such as Toxodon, were driven to extinction due to their failure to adapt to the onslaught of the northern predators. A lot of the southern animals that managed to make it to North America, such as the glyptodont, a giant relative of the armadillo, as well as the pterobirds, did not survive long as they failed to compete for resources with the already established animals. But not all South American animals failed to adapt. The marsupial opossum is one of the most successful animals of the interchange, having moved to the north from the south, and still prospers throughout North America today. Although this particular chapter in the history of life may have ended, its story continues to this day. The descendants of the animals that participated in this mass migration, such as llamas and opossums, still inhabit and thrive in our world today. The fossils of those who did not survive allow us to look back at a time when North and South America met.